president speaking from the diplomatic reception room in the White House residence will be delivering one of his familiar fireside chats and is expected to talk to the American people on the year-old war which began with the sneak attack by the Japanese in Hawaii on December 7th of last year. Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States.
My fellow Americans, this war is a new kind of war. It is different from all other wars of the past, not only in its methods and weapons, but also in its geography. It is warfare in terms of every continent, every island, every sea, every air lane in the world.
See any lipstick on me?
Lipstick? No.
No? Princess sure did. Well, that girl's got eagle eyes when it comes to spotting lipstick on me. If I ain't got nothing on me, she probably slapped it off.
Is she taking?
Have a sit down. Stick and rudder. You a pilot? No? Me neither. But I will be as soon as Uncle Sam finishes kicking my ass and pinning them wings on me.
You fellas on your way to Tuskegee?
Yes, sir.
Oh, but you do?
Finally.
Yes, I am.
Excuse me?
A licensed pilot.
Damn. I bet he didn't even have to take the test. Billy Roberts. On the block, they call me Train. As an A-Train, you know, quickest way to Harlem, you know.
Block?
Lenox at 125th. What block you from?
I'm from a small town in Iowa. Ottumwa.
Iowa? I didn't know they had colored folk in Iowa. Now I guess I got living proof sitting here right next to me. What'd you get on that exam there, Iowa?
98.
98, that's very good.
Oh, so you did take that test. That is very good, you know, but it ain't as good as mine, which is 100. But congratulations on being second best. Here we go.
Move it up front, now. Let's go. Move it, boy.
All right, all right.
I'm gonna ask you to do it again, damn it.
Well, excuse me, please.
Bro, I don't know. But why are we getting off the train?
Hey. See that? I call you all on this now for white folks only. That's why you're getting off.
Keep in line now. One behind the other. Time.
German prisoners.
Make way.
Well, I'll be damned. Jim, throw cars in the front, boys.
You gonna give up our seats for German prisoners of war?
Train's leaving, boy. Either get on or back off.
Tuskegee Army Airfield. I'm Colonel Noel Rogers, the commanding officer. This is Major Sherman Joy, Director of Training, and Lieutenant Glenn, liaison officer. It is the task of myself, Major Joy, Lieutenant Glenn, and others at this training facility to train and evaluate you men as potential combat pilots. There have been many obstacles on the road to getting you here. Now that you are here, the only obstacle you will encounter will be how quick you learn, how well you obey orders, and how expert you fly. If I am the first to tell you that your being here is an experiment, take time to understand just what that means. There are people in very high places wondering if this will succeed. If I and my staff have anything to say about it, it will. However, we will cut no corners. We will allow no favors. Our business is killing our enemies from the air as efficiently and expeditiously as we know how. Now, assuming you make it through this training, that task will be your honor. Lieutenant, Major.
Why did you join the Air Corps? Cadet.
Sir.
I don't like repeating myself, Cadet.
Serve my country, sir.
Your country? Boy, are you stupid?
No, sir.
You people. Now, don't you know how bad we treat you people? Serving your country? This ain't your country. Your country's full of apes and gorillas. Malaria. Missionaries.
Ain't no gorillas in Harlem.
Why'd you join the Air Corps, boy?
This country has enemies, sir, and there are people who need protecting from those enemies.
What people, nigga?
All people, sir. To my knowledge, the Germans aren't sparing the colors.
To my knowledge, the colored aren't up to fighting the Germans, let alone beating them.
Max Schmeling found out differently, sir.
Well, you know what? My job is to see if you Joe Lewis's can fly. Now, in case the colonel gave you the wrong impression, let me clear it up. You are nothing special.
You just heard two very different speeches from two very different officers. I hope you were paying attention. It is my job as liaison officer to ease your transition to military life. Reveille's at 0600, PT's at 0630, and breakfast is at 0730. At the top of the military command structure is President Roosevelt as commander-in-chief. At the bottom is you, the cadet. Everything you need can and will be found on this base. Everything you need to know has the words U.S. Army Air Corps written on the cover. If it doesn't, you don't need it.
You got weekends.
Kind of figured that would happen.
Yeah. Seems possible. Yeah. Yeah. You ready for all of this? I mean, we in the army now, boy.
Well, it's not a tumor, but I've been ready for this for a long time.
Hey, what about you, Walter?
Well, Stick? Stick was born ready. He probably popped out his mama with a full bomb load.
Come graduation, none of y'all's names will be in front of mine.
Oh, is that right?
Guaranteed.
Well, what might that name be there, Reverend Bookworm? Stick or Rudder?
Peebles. Walter Derrick, the third. Aeronautical engineer.
Hannibal Lee, Jr., pre-med.
Lewis Johns, English literature.
William A. Train Roberts, political science.
Roy Jonas Cappy, art history.
Andrew Turner, sociology.
Charles Tate, halfback, all-rounder.
William Pitts, economics.
Class, attend.
Sure.
Take your seats. Take one and pass them back.
What is this? What is this?
Permission to speak, sir.
What is it, Cadet?
Sir, I believe we've already taken this test before.
Yep.
No, I believe you'll take it again.
May the cadet ask why, sir?
You don't have time for an explanation, Cadet. You have 1 hour for this exam. Begin and end on my mark.
Name and element. Cadet Lee.
Water, sir.
Any others? Cadet Johns.
Earth, sir.
Cadet Peebles.
Air, sir.
Cappy.
Fire, sir.
Water, air, earth, and fire. Of these elements, I direct your attention to air and fire. Although it is your privilege to live in the air, it is your destiny to die by fire. Many of you will wash out before you ever set foot in an airplane. Others will die during primary flight training. Still others in advanced. When you die, we will cross off your name, close ranks, and carry on. Now, any of you ever been up in an airplane before?
Yes, sir, when I was in college, sir. I have a pilot's license, sir.
Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Well, follow me, Mr. Lindbergh.
All right, peoples, let's see what you're made of.
He's trying to wear a stick out. Doing it on purpose, too.
Yeah, well, you had enough, flyboy!
I want you to read your flight manual cover to cover and know it like the Holy Bible.
Yes, sir.
That goes for all of you. Is that clear?
Yes, sir!
Hey, you. Cadet Peoples. Why'd you join the Air Corps, boy?
I ain't thinking about Major Joy. You just another door in the way.
Another crack in the box.
Another peck in the woods.
I just want to serve my country, sir.
What country? You don't have a country. Goddamn uppity nigger son of a bitch.
Oh, I was real sorry, sir. Your country.
Uppity niggers turn into strange fruit where I come from.
Strange what?
Nigga hanging from a tree. Just swinging from a hangman's fine as he. Talk back Joe was his name. All three. Massa shut his mouth, then turned to me. Lord, Massa shut his mouth, then he turned to me.
Did you learn that in English Lit, Johns?
My great-granddaddy told me that sitting on his knee.
It's a hell of a bedtime story.
As director of training, I assumed I had the authority to conduct any testing I thought necessary, sir.
That assumption was incorrect, Major. These men have all previously been tested. What possible reason could you have for testing them again?
The previous test scores themselves, sir. 90s, 100s. I've long had my suspicions about the accuracy of those scores.
You think they cheated to get here?
A lot of people dream to be pilots, Colonel. Many will stop at nothing to become one. Eliminating dishonest, untrainable cadets will save my staff time and aggravation.
I see. I'll hear the answer to your retest. I had the results sent over as soon as they were compiled. I, too, have curiosity, Major, though I suspect my motives are somewhat different. Cadet Lewis Johns, 98. Cadet Billy Roberts, 100. Cadet Walter Peoples, 100. Cadet Hannibal Lee, 100. I could go on. No one scored less than 95.
Sir, these people are taking up training slots that would be better filled by real pilots. Damn it, sir, there's a war on.
Yes, Major, there is. And I'd prefer that war was not on this base. That'll be all, Major.
PT-17, fuel capacity and engine. Cadet Johns,
fuel 46 gallons, engine 220 horsepower, Continental, sir.
Left spin recovery technique. Cadet Peoples.
Right rudder, stop rotation, sharp forward stick, pull out from dive, sir.
All right, let's go up.
I like to step on his balls.
Cadet Lewis Johns, just taught you men the most important lesson you'll learn here at Tuskegee. If you don't believe in God, you better find a damn good substitute. Thank you.
Miss Chow?
I wasn't hungry.
Can I give you a hand?
I don't need a hand.
What the hell is eating you, Cappy?
Three more washed out today. Bradley, Wade, and Patterson. Wade just broke down and walked off the base. And Lewis, I can't get him out of my head.
You're gonna get your chance to solo, Leroy. You're gonna make it. We're all gonna make it.
That's bullshit, Hannibal. And you know it. We're not all gonna make it. When we first got here, this barracks was filled. Look at it now. One third of our guys are gone, and we're only halfway through this program.
So what? Big deal. I know I'm gonna make it, Leroy. That's all that matters. What about you? You gonna make it?
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know?
Look, I said I don't know, okay?
No. It's not okay. It's the wrong damn answer. Now the question is, are you gonna make it? Because if you don't think you will, you won't. And then you will have failed. You will have failed your family, you will have failed your friends, and most importantly, you will have failed yourself. Can you live with that?
No.
Are you going to make it?
Yeah.
You say it like you mean it, Cadet.
I'm going to make it.
Fight, fighting 99th. Rat-tat, rat-tat-tat, down in fact they go. Fighting men of the 99th, send them down below, for we are heroes of the night. To hell with the Axis might. Fight, 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 fighting 99. Drink up, raise those cups to those gallant men, to the gallant men. Flying cross of flame, oh God, red, white, blue.
Any questions on the film you just saw? No questions. Timidness is a characteristic that gets fighter pilots killed, gentlemen.
So where's Major Joy? I was assumed that he was teaching air combat techniques.
And why is that?
Cadet. Because he's white and I'm colored. Come on, spit it out, man. No disrespect. It's just a matter of experience. Sir. Another assumption.
Well, I'm going to give you the facts, Cadet. Out of 150 U.S. Army officers on this base, you are looking at the only one with actual air combat experience. I have 3 109 kills. And I've had a Spitfire and a Hurricane shot out from under me. Both times behind enemy lines. And both times, I escaped.
But the Air Corps didn't allow color flyers. How'd you do that?
He went north. Royal Canadian Air Force. Right, Lieutenant?
48 missions. Now, if you don't think I have anything to teach you, you are free to walk out of that door. My job is to teach you basic air combat tactics. Your next training machine, the AT-6. Bank without a turn. If you learn nothing else, learn this one. It will save your life. It starts with a hard bank.
Hey, Peoples, you're supposed to be trying to get away.
Yeah? Well, you're looking at the man who put the dog in dogfight.
I've got your ass now, Walter. Come on, Walter, you didn't expect me to fall for that.
Fall for this. Hey, where the hell are you? Look behind your ass, Iowa. Ben, you are dead.
Damn, where'd you learn that?
Just made it up, man. Just made it up.
Come on, people. You don't expect me to believe you just made that up. Where'd you learn it?
Same place I learned this.
Hey, you're too low. We can't buzz the field. Walter!
See that we have much choice, Colonel. I've already lost one instructor when that boy Johns crashed and burned. This last stunt could have cost us another plane and pilot. Besides, I've had my doubts about Cadet Peoples for some time. He and that boy Hannibal are showboats with attitudes to get men killed.
And what do you think, Lieutenant? It's a damn fool thing to do, sir. But I've seen the Air Corps overlook worse.
Would you trust that pilot on your wing in combat?
He's one of the few that I would trust.
Well, maybe there's a reason for that, apart from his flying abilities.
I've flown with white pilots in actual combat who don't have his skills, sir.
When these men arrived, I told them no corners would be cut for them. They were going to have to be held to the highest standards of the service.
But is it fair for that standard be higher than any other group of men? It was simple, youthful exuberance, Colonel!
I'm doing a difficult job as well as I can, Lieutenant. That'll be all, gentlemen.
Our test scores don't mean everything, do they, Colonel?
I said that we'll be all, Major.
Yes, change, huh?
sorry.
You can understand.
I wish there was something I could do.
See any margin at all, sir.
Permission to speak, sir.
What is it?
I made a mistake, sir. It won't happen again.
That's right, Peoples. It won't. You're out.
Colonel, I did something really stupid. I'll take any punishment you give, but please don't put me out of the program. Not now.
Tell my hands are tired.
I can't go home like this.
Home? If it was up to me, boy, you'd be going into the infantry.
Major! I got a right to fight for what I believe in like anybody else. I'm the best pilot in this damn place.
Get a grip! Break off!
People!
Stop there, boy! Break off!
Graduation day, no name call will be higher than mine. Guaranteed.
Took it right after his solo. He's gonna send it home to his folks.
Give it a rest, Train. Let them pack up his things. Billy, it's not our job.
No!
Back off, okay?
No!
They'll take care of it. I told you.
No! No! They killed him. Hannibal, they killed him. Major Joyce set out to break him, and he did. Just as clean as if he put a carbine to his head.
He was my friend, too.
Get off me.
You know he's right, Hannibal. You know, this shit doesn't make any sense. Why are they even bothering? I mean, they might as well just forget it and send us home.
You want to go home, Cappy? Shove off. You two, Train, go on. Tuck your tail between your legs and run back to Harlem. Make Major Joy happy. Me too, for that matter. I'd sooner be here by my lonesome than to play with a pair of jokers who can't figure out the game. Don't you see, that's what he wants us to do. He wants us to quit. He wants us all to wash out. I'm not going to give him the satisfaction. I came here for one reason. To do one thing. To learn how to fly. I'm going to do that. And I ain't going to let you stop me.
I didn't say that.
Not you, not Major Joy, not the goddamn commander-in-chief himself. You reading me, Train?
What's going on?
nothing, sir. Just a little discussion, sir.
Well, while you're cleaning up, add this to your discussion. You lost a friend today. And I understand how you feel. But you better get over it. Quick! Friends die in our business, and for a lot of reasons. And the only protection you have against losing one is not to have any. As you were.
I'm losing manifold pressure.
Roberts, break formation.
Yes, sir.
Lieutenant Glenn, it's pretty bad. I gotta put her down.
You passed the country road about a mile back. Stay with him, Lee.
Yes, sir.
Hang on, Captain.
Little engine trouble.
Son of a bitch. They're niggers.
Base color flies.
Lieutenant Roberts. Congratulations.
Lieutenant Tompkins, sir.
Congratulations, Lieutenant.
Lieutenant Cappy.
Congratulations, Lieutenant.
Thank you, sir.
Lieutenant Lee. Congratulations, Lieutenant.
Thank you, Colonel.
Thank you, Lieutenant.
What you men have accomplished, given the odds against it, your friends back home could only dream about. And your families watching today never imagined. You are among a select few who will ever know the honor of serving their country in the realm of flight. You are now United States Army Air Corps Aviators. For that achievement, I congratulate you.
There they go. Got it. night. To hell with the Axis might. Fight.
We Americans will contribute unified acceptance of sacrifice and of effort. That means a national unity that can know no limitations of race or creed or selfish politics. The American people expect that much from themselves.
Gentlemen, this meeting is adjourned. I understand your position, Beach, but it's a very sticky subject, particularly in the Negro press.
And I've said this committee should not be concerned with the Negro press. However, I know a dead horse when I beat one. So I think this might inject a little courage into the more timid of our colleagues.
What's that?
It's a scientific study that I was commissioned by the anthropology department of one of our most prestigious universities. The credentials of its authors are as unimpeachable as its conclusions. Look at this. The intellectual capacity of the Negro in respect to the operation of complicated machinery, i.e. a frontline warplane, is questionable. And down here, smaller blood vessels in the Negro translates to restricted blood supply and problems in severe maneuvers.
There are documented reports of mysterious training crashes at Tuskegee. Blacking out and losing control might very well explain them.
Might very well.
When does the full committee get the report?
In due time. Right now, it's under lock and key. I got a few more ducks to line up before I make my move and see that this Tuskegee nonsense is finally brought to an end. As God is my witness, those boys will never see combat.
General Stevenson, I wish I had more time to prepare for this visit, sir.
So in the hell do I, Colonel.
Mrs. Roosevelt.
Colonel Rogers is the commanding officer at Tuskegee. As I mentioned on the phone, the First Lady is here to take a look at the operations, Colonel.
Well, maybe a little background might be in order, ma'am, before we start with the tour of the facilities. The field sits on 1,600 acres and is one of the largest in the country.
How would you gauge the progress of your colored flyers, Colonel?
I'd say their progress is commensurate with the standards of the training command, ma'am.
Plain English, Colonel. Does that mean you are or aren't satisfied?
I am very satisfied, ma'am.
Good. Then I want a ride in one of your airplanes.
Major, take the First Lady up in that Stearman over there. Take a couple of loops around
no.
the field.
I want a ride with him. Is there a problem, gentlemen? I thought you said these men were trained. Surely the addition of an old lady in the rear seat won't unravel that confidence.
No, ma'am.
Good. And when I'm finished, you can also tell me why these pilots are still here and not overseas fighting for their country like the rest of our boys.
Roosevelt, Lieutenant Lee.
Good afternoon, young man.
Good afternoon.
It's turned into a beautiful day for an airplane ride.
Yes, ma'am.
That isn't who I think it is it?
Lieutenant Lee is about to make all your dreams come true.
What do you mean?
Take a good look around you, gentlemen. I suspect Alabama will soon become a fond memory.
Hold it, please. Smile.
Don't tell me I spelled your name wrong, sir. I mean, how can you screw up the league?
No, you spelled it right. Just never had my own plane before.
Well, it's not yours, Lieutenant. It's mine. I put your name on it so you think it's yours. Sergeant Toby Wills, sir. Your crew chief. Call me Tank.
Nice to meet you, Tank. I'm Helen. Don't you worry. I'll take care of your plane just like it was mine.
I want to welcome you men to North Africa. For those of you who don't know me, I am Lieutenant Colonel Benjamin O. Davis, commander of the 99th Pursuit Squadron. Tomorrow morning, you'll get an opportunity to meet the entire 33rd Fighter Group. Despite the long and hard road you've traveled, and the many obstacles that have been thrown in your path, you have arrived. I want you to know I'm proud of you. Welcome to the war, gentlemen.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's a long day. I'd be glad to get
that. Well, there's a class act.
You said it, brother.
B.O. Davis. You know, he's a lot shorter than what I pictured.
Yep, well, West Point will do that to a colored man.
What do you mean?
It means that he was silenced the entire time that he was at West Point. Nobody talked to him. But he never gave up.
No. That's right.
He just kept on in. Like Walter said, just a matter of focus.
Hey, train, we're starting up.
Yep. Yeah. Poker calls, gents. Gotta take a pot.
Good luck, Billy.
Huh. You know, it's so beautiful out here. I should have brought my water covers.
Yeah. Never knew there was a war going on.
Oh, you got that right.
How you doing? Ready to have what you got. Lift off time is 0700. Lieutenant, you.
It's the Buffalo Soldiers. Day late and a dollar short.
Take a seat, Lieutenant.
Yes, sir.
I guess we can begin our briefing.
Why wasn't I informed that the briefing had been pushed up?
You and your men are expected to read the board just like everybody else.
The board said 0600.
I'd look again, Colonel.
They changed it.
Same old, same old. We'll be back in Alabama.
Lee, Roberts, Cappy.
Sir.
We're flying in Europe. Follow me and I'll brief you on the way.
Yes, sir.
Taken out. German Tiger divisions have been kicking the shit out of our ground forces, but are now low on fuel and munitions. G2 thinks this yard is the supply depot. Our job is to make those supplies disappear.
Just ahead, over that ridge. We gotta knock out the German supply trains. It's the top. 5 miles to target. Okay, let's show them what we're made of.
Go get them, Hannibal!
Hannibal, Z, 3, and...
Fire!
Yeah!
For your first mission, you guys did damn good. I see Lieutenant Glenn trained you well. I like that.
Thank you, sir.
9 months of practice didn't hurt, sir.
I checked that attitude, Lieutenant. Go get your sleep. We have a briefing tomorrow at 0530. Stretch our range. Don't suck your tanks dry. Or it's a long camel ride back home. You fellas stay in tight formation. There's safety in numbers.
Safety from what, sir? Circling buzzard? I haven't seen the cherry since we've been here.
That doesn't mean they're not out there. Dual targets this morning. The Sherman Airfield, then the power station.
Turn out.
Excuse me, Colonel Davis.
Yes?
When do you think we'll be seeing some air combat, sir?
You in a hurry? Is that Lieutenant Lee?
No, sir, but we've been doing nothing but ground runs. The white units have already rotated out to France. Why haven't we?
If you're not in a hurry to die, you must have something to prove.
With all due respect to the colonel as a West Point graduate, your father being the first Negro appointed general in the United States military, sir, I think we all have something to prove.
Don't you dream of jeopardizing this mission with your glory seeking. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
Going after the first target.
Wants to see us.
Us?
Us, yeah, you guys, me.
Lieutenants Lee, Cappy, and Roberts reporting his order, General. Gentlemen, relax, have a seat. I'm General Stevenson. This is Senator Conyers. General, I believe we've met before. It was back at Tuskegee with Mrs. Roosevelt. You're the one who took her up? Yes, sir. She can barrel roll with the best of them, sir.
And that's what would that mean?
It's a maneuver, sir.
Gentlemen, we all have things to do, so let's move on. The senator and I are on a final swing of a fact-finding tour.
Through the war zone.
Wanting to see how you boys are settling in.
We've been getting reports, which require some clarification.
We have critics back in the States, Lieutenant.
I wasn't aware of any criticism, sir.
Well, let me make you aware. Inability to locate targets, failure to press home attacks or find secondary targets when the first is obscured, attitude problems with fellow officers, poor formation discipline, cowardice.
Excuse me? Lieutenant. Senator,
I'm here to talk with the pilots. I'm not interested in practiced excuses. I thought I made that clear. So what do you guys think they'll reassign Colonel Davis?
We don't know that he's been reassigned.
Well, I don't see him out here anywhere. They're probably going to punish him by sticking him behind a desk. Lord knows it's the worst thing you can do to a pilot.
Boy, it was sure as shooting kill me. Shit, bandits, 2 o'clock.
109!
Finally some action. Let's get them, boys.
Leroy. Cappy, get back in formation now. They're probably just recon. They won't attack us if we stick together.
Here
Here's our chance for some kills. Come on!
In terms of character, the Negro has been observed to be both childish and impulsive.
Now, gentlemen, you must agree that this report is highly inflammatory.
I have on my desk a War Department memo on a colored pilot recently shot down in North Africa after breaking formation. As a description, impulsive quite appears the appropriate terminology.
Maybe, but this report smacks of a singular point of view.
Well, all points of view are singular if they're not to your liking, Senator. Meanwhile, I've got constituents who wonder why, when they're suffering from war rationing and overtaxation, why we're spending their tax dollars on a bunch of college-educated niggers who've convinced the press that they can fly expensive warplanes.
Gentlemen, this experiment certainly had noble beginnings. The failures are evident and glaring. Perhaps the thing to do is abandon this project until after the war, when calmer conditions will allow for a more thoughtful approach.
Where are you going?
To give a representative of the accused an opportunity to defend himself. General Stevenson, you know, this is Lieutenant Colonel Benjamin O. Davis, the commanding officer of the squadron in question. Be seated.
Colonel, you are aware of the accusations, such as malaise and fatigue in the face of little enemy contact?
We've been in continuous combat for months with no replacements, sir. My men are tired. Other units get four fresh bodies a month, but something always seems to go wrong with our paperwork or movement orders.
How many missions have your men flown, Colonel?
Most have flown well over 50, which is the standard cutoff point at which white pilots are sent home.
And your men are still flying?
They don't know what else to do with us, sir. White pilots rotate back to the States as instructors, but since the Army won't allow colored pilots to train white cadets...
9 months training. Countless missions in Africa, and not one air-to-air kill. Isn't that right?
We can't fight, but we don't see. We've been stationed so far from frontline action, we rarely encounter an enemy plane, let alone the opportunity to engage one.
You recently lost a pilot who cut and ran from, what, an imaginary Messerschmitt?
Those men understand Lieutenant Cappy's action was a mistake.
Stakes are all we see, young man. Late for mission briefings.
piss-poor discipline and leadership, and nothing but excuses. What I see is a unit that's an embarrassment to the Air Corps, to the American people, and to themselves. Might I remind you, gentlemen, that this war is by no means won, and this sad experiment is a drain and a hindrance to that effort. My vote is that we abandon the project and move the agenda.
All we asked for was a chance to prove ourselves, a fair and impartial opportunity. We thought we had that chance. But you invite us to a poker game, hand us a fixed deck, and then wonder why we can't win.
Young man, we really don't...
Let him finish, sir.
Every colored pilot in the 99th went to his own private hell to wear those wings. Every one of those men carry not only the burden of their dreams of becoming American military aviators, but the hopes of an entire people as well. Am I the only one in this room that understands just what that means? I was brought up to believe that beneath it all, Americans are a decent people with an abiding sense of integrity and fair play. The cheers I heard across this country when Joe Louis and Jesse Owens humiliated Hitler's master race didn't just come from proud colored folks. They came from everyone. How are we to interpret that? As a United States Army officer who gladly puts his life on the line every day, there's no greater conflict within me. How do I feel about my country? And how does my country feel about me? Are we only to be Americans when the mood suits you? A fair and impartial opportunity is all we ask. Nothing that you yourselves wouldn't demand.
Master switch off.
Wally. Kansas.
Consolation, the word's in, it was a good strike.
Well,
boss has my crew up there, Colonel. My book, that's the shit end of the stick. The fighter escort never even made the rendezvous point.
Said they ran into some trouble en route, took some pretty heavy casualties of their own.
Damn. He always got some sort of excuse. Me, I got parts of four kids all over that tank countryside because of their limptic excuses.
Captain, you're forgetting yourself.
Take your seats, gentlemen.
Son of a bitch. Colonel's gone full bird.
I have good news, and I have not so good news. The good news. We have been reassigned to the European theater. We're going to Italy.
See some action, huh?
However, there will be some changes. Once in Italy, the 99th Pursuit Squadron will be joined by three new squadrons from Tuskegee. The 100th, 301st, and 302nd Fighter Squadrons will now comprise the 332nd Fighter Group.
They're all colored units. We're going to be segregated again.
In addition, our mission has changed from dive bombing to bomber escort.
Why has our mission changed, sir? I mean, why all of a sudden are we chaperones?
The Flying Fortresses are taking heavy losses and need effective cover.
Sir, with all due respect, why don't they let the white pilots cover them?
I don't have time to lay it all out for you. I will say this. This entire unit came within a hillbilly's heartbeat of going home. And if certain people had their way, coming back carrying rifles, if we came back at all.
Say, you fellas with the 99th?
Yeah.
Reggie Miller, 332nd.
I believe. Nice to meet you. This is Billy Roberts.
Call me Train.
Hey, Train. Well, fellas, welcome to Ramatelli. Hey, right this way.
You mean Ramadamtelli?
About time you showed up, Lieutenant. I thought I'd ship you in North Africa.
Not a chance, sir.
Damn, it's good to see you, Tank.
Good to see you, sir. Remind me, I have something I want to show you later.
All right. See you out on the floor.
Take care, sir.
Stanley.
Sir.
I'm dependent upon you and the others in the 99th to show some guidance, some leadership. These kids are straight out of Tuskegee and still saying their prayers tonight. So do us all a favor and give them some help. Roger.
By the way, Colonel, I still do.
Still do what, Lieutenant?
Still say my prayers at night.
You gotta be kidding me.
No, sir.
Brand new Mustangs?
Yes, sir. Gallons with drop tanks. You can ride these ponies 1,000 miles and back. Six different calibers in the wings, and she can haul 2 1,000-pounders. You don't bring me back some swastikas with all this? Just keep flying right on back to Octopus, Iowa.
Otumwa. What's this?
New signature from the group. Do you like it?
It ain't loud enough. It ain't the whole goddamn tail of that tank.
Yes, sir, Lieutenant.
We are less than 90 minutes from the German border, and they know we're here. Those of you wondering about seeing action, you got your wish. The 33rd and 324th regularly tangle with the Jerrys.
Colonel, they're flying bomber escort.
Occasionally, Lieutenant, yes.
They're doing it occasionally. We have the honor of doing it full time.
That's right, Lieutenant. Consider it an honor. Bomber losses to enemy action are unacceptably high. Yesterday's run into Germany cost them 65 of 200 bombers. That's 1 in 3, gentlemen. 600 men killed or missing. You want to make your mark? Here's a chance.
Thank you.
girls, all dressed up and no dates.
Yeah, I think we've been stood up. Not a B-17 in sight.
This is the rendezvous point. They must have been grounded by bad weather.
He's coming back around!
Hey, Iowa, turn to Channel 8.
All right, Medina, come on, let's get him! Take him off!
Sounds like one of ours.
Must be stragglers.
Let's go get my hand.
Roger that.
Those markings.
Well, I gotta find them. I got a bottle of whiskey for both of them, for saving our asses.
Hey, you might try Ramitelli. We're getting new escort assignments. They might be one of them.
All right, I'll check it out.
Hornslop did everything but pull the trigger for me.
On that last kill, took that son of a bitch out from 1,000 yards.
Hey, so what you use to get them off? You split S climbing turns?
No. Walter people special. You make it up as you go along.
Hey, how you guys doing? Listen, we're B-17 bomb group based at Foja, and we're looking for the pilots who were up at Clevin yesterday. We want to say thanks. A couple of those guys saved our asses.
Don't mention it.
So where are they?
Where's who?
Pilots, boy. Came up here to see pilots.
You're looking at them. Lieutenant Lee, Lieutenant Roberts.
How are you?
Appreciate your thanks.
This whole base is colored?
Colored, yes. Lock, stock, and pilot. Let's get out of here, Lieutenant.
What?
He's in right. Let's get out of here.
That's not right. He just said.
I don't give a shit what he said. Them pilots was niggers. Niggers weren't flying them planes today. Let's move it out.
Yes, sir.
You saved their asses, and they got the nerve to be insulted. Makes you want to hurt somebody.
What are you writing?
What folks?
This boy mails a letter to his folks every night.
I'm not mailing this one, Train. You are.
Oh, no. I am not mailing that letter. If you die, you mail it yourself.
You'll mail it just like I'll mail yours.
Well, you won't have to worry about me asking. Writing them one of those letters is like expecting to die.
No one expects to die. My father had a friend who fought in the First World War. He's one of the first colored soldiers in France. This man had so many medals, he came home decorated like a Christmas tree. He disappeared one night. They found him in Georgia. Lynched in his uniform.
Why would you want to fly for a country that thanks you by lynching you?
I like the feeling of respect that we get, especially from colored folks. Like
Cappy came upon them fellas in the chain gang back at training in Tuskegee. I even got some satisfaction out of the look on those white fellas' faces today when they found out it was us that saved their tails.
Captain, that colored outfit, 332nd, HQ confirmed they were the boys that helped us in Plevin, and we weren't even their assignment.
Lieutenant, let me give you a little sociology lesson. I think being from California and all, you might be a little bit confused. Now, I'm a Texas boy. I grew up with niggers. I was around them every day. Hell, in Lubbock, you can't throw a rock without hitting one. Now, I know how they think, and I know how they live, and I can tell you with complete certainty what they are and are not capable of.
And you don't think they could fly them planes, sir?
Vance, if they were flying them planes, and that is one hell of a big if, then what happened up there was a fluke. So forget about it.
You know, Train, I'm getting tired of these long missions where we get stuck out here by our lonesome.
I'm low on fuel. I say we should head back.
Wait a second. What is that?
Where?
Down below. Looks like a German destroyer.
Ain't one of ours.
Train, you thinking what I'm thinking?
Always.
Straighten up.
Fly right.
Papa, don't you blow your top.
Spotlight in there, man. Sunk a damn destroyer. People get medals for doing that shit.
You're gonna stand there and tell me you think they're gonna give you or me or anybody else on this base a medal for doing anything right?
Okay. All right, so you won't get a medal. Bottom line is, we know what you did. We know it was a lucky shot. But it's still one destroyer down.
Round him!
right.
I got a train.
Get this guy off me. I won't get him off me.
I'm coming.
Billy Roberts, on the block they call me Train. As an A train, you know, quickest way to Harlem.
Colonel, just how bad will the 88s be?
They'll be attacking Berlin, son. Very hard of Germany. Every anti-aircraft gun in the region will be trying to stop you. And then there'll be the fighters. Now, gentlemen, on this one, we need every load placed on the target. We may not have a second chance.
Sir?
Yes?
Who's flying cover?
51st will escort your wing, Lieutenant. Now, any more questions? If not, good luck.
Sir, why the change? How come our escort was changed from the 332nd to the 51st?
Logistics, Captain. Is that a problem?
No, sir, no problem.
Good. Have a good mission.
Sir.
You got a point to make, Captain? I suggest you get on with it. Speak up, Captain. We got a mission to run here.
Yes, sir. Well, I got men whose lives are my responsibility up there, sir. And I want the 332nd as our escort.
Colored boys?
That's right, sir. I looked into it, and since they've been escorting bombers, they haven't lost one to enemy action, sir. Not a single ship. And if it's all the same to you, I want the 332nd to take me to Berlin and back.
All right, Captain. I'll take it under advisement.
You're up awfully early today.
I haven't gotten much sleep, sir.
We're all going to miss him, Adam. The really sad thing is he's going to miss this. Distinguished Flying Cross. Taking out the destroyer. General Crow will be here next week to officially present it to you. There's something else.
Sir.
Congratulations. Captain Lee. The word's in about our next mission. Assigned. We were requested.